Hey there, what's up? How are you guys doing? Welcome to our channel. And this is the fifth video of our exciting series, Build Jarvis in Real Life. And today in this video, we're going to connect all the things that we have done till now in a single thing to make our virtual assistant working properly. So we're going to connect the listen, speak, and our AI model to make a working virtual assistant. So sit back, relax, and let's get started. All right, so this was the code that we have done previously in our video. All right, so today in this video, we're going to connect all the things. So we have models and head folder right over here. So this trash folder is just an empty folder, right? So you don't have to create this. Right now, I have some files stored inside, so I'm not going to delete it, but you don't have to create it as well, all right? So first of all, let us import our necessary model. So first of all, we're going to import the speak function from this head folder. So let me write from head.speak file, import the speak function. And we're going to import the AI model as well from the models folder. From AI, from models.ai, import AI. I think the name of the function is like this, all right? So if you don't know what are these models and what are this file, what type of file are those, then you can check our previous videos, all right, so that you will get to know more about these files. All right, so as we are going to make our virtual assistant to work properly to listen and process our query and then respond us by speaking, so there are two ways to do that. First of all, we can do all the thing in this speech to text. When the speech to text is being called from the front end by getting the data, so what we can do is we'll create a variable called response here. We will initialize the AI function, and here inside we'll pass the query of the user so that we'll get the response of that with rest variable, and we'll speak out the response. All right, so like this we can do as well. All right, so let me show you the demo of this. Hey there, what's up,
sir? Still managing the intricacies of Mr. Stock's life.
All right, there you go. It is working properly, but we're not going to do this thing. All right, suppose this is the like fifth video in this series. We're going to make our pro like job is top notch, so there will be a lot of things that we need to write. So we are not going to do all the thing in this single route speech to text, where you we're going to use this speech to text route to handle all this text to speech conversion thing, and we're going to create a new route that will handle all the responses related to AI, generating AI responses. All right, so first of all, let us create a route that will handle all the thing for the AI response. All right, so let me remove this thing and let me copy this. All right, so speech to text. So let me change the function name to get AI response. And the method will be post and get AI response. All right, and here data equals not data. Let me replace it with the query. Query equals request dot get json dot get query. Okay, all right, now we got the query inside the query variable. Then we'll call our function AI response equals AI query. Let us pass the query right over here, and then we'll print the response, and in the return statement will return the JSON. So let me import JSONify by using this model JSONify, and inside here query is to user query, and then response will be response. All right, so now let me go in the index.html, and inside the index.html we need to make some few changes. Alright. So here, whenever we get the query, we're calling the function speech to text. Alright. So first of all, we'll fetch generate AI response function. This one. Fetch generate AI response. Response and the method will be post content type application JSON. JSON by query equals query. We are sending the query again, okay. And then dot then response dot JSON and console dot log data. All right. So whenever we are sending the data, whenever we send something inside this AI, whenever we send our query inside this. Alright, so whenever we send our query inside this function, this route, then it will return us the response. Alright, so we'll pass the response in this speech to text. So whenever we got this response.json, then in the data, let me hit the enter. Alright, so inside this, first of all, we're going to convert it into a function type like, alright, curly bracket, and first of all, we'll console log the data. And here, we will fetch this thing. We'll fetch this speech to text inside this, whenever we get the data. Means whenever we get the data, then only it's going to be fetched. All right. So if we got any error, then the error will be printed in the console. And whenever we got any response, then only the speech to text will be called from the front end. All right. So speech to text method will post application JSON and JSON.stringify. We are not going to send the query right over here. We are going to send the response that we'll get from the front end right over here. So let me create a variable called response equals data dot response. So this uppercase one, data dot response, and then we're going to pass the response, the AI response. All right, now I think we are good to go. And after getting the data, it will console the data, which is okay. All right, so response in this speech to text, we need to dot get, wait a second, copy this whole thing, put it right over here, copy this response, and we'll get the response, and then we will make it speak response data. Okay, so let me run. Hey, what's up?
Greetings, sir. It's a pleasure to serve you. I'm Jarvis, the artificial intelligence system at your disposal. How may I assist you today, Mr. Stock?
Okay, so we got the response like this, which is pretty cool. All right, so now let us update this thing in the front end in the HTML. First, let me just do a quick styling right over here. Center tag H1. All right. Here, whenever we got the response, then document.getElementById this one. Aligned. Document.getElementById result. Our text content will be AI response. All right. Jarvis, I like short and concise response. So I want you to generate your response, short and concise. All right, so you can see it is working absolutely fine. We are getting the result in the front end as well, and we're getting the data. All right, so now.
Understood, sir. I'll keep it brief.
Let me remove this console.log, and our squeeze function is too slow. All right, so I'm going to fix that later. What is 2 plus 2? What is 2 plus 2 query and answer response? Okay, so you can see the response is
4, sir.
Fast. All right, so that's it. You can see in this video, we have connected our front end with the back end as well, and we have created, like, we have got an AI that will listen us, that will process our query and return us the output. All right. So in the upcoming video, we're going to do more than that. And also we're going to work on the GUI as well. We're going to create some modern GUI, and we're going to do that together. So yeah, that's all. And I want you to like this video and subscribe this channel if you don't want to miss any update. And I'll catch you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.